It's the last day of photography week. I hope you've had as much fun as I have. Snag your copy of the photography bundle before it's gone. I hope that you have checked it out. If you haven't, click the link below. At least give it a look because I'd hate for you to miss it. And you go check it out, go to check it out later and it's gone and it's something that could have helped you grow as a photographer. We all know that investing in photography can be quite expensive. But bundles like this I think are incredible, and it's something I wish I'd had when I was starting out, to be able to have all these resources from all these professional photographers at your fingertips that you can go through as slow as you want instead of having to invest in course after course after course. You're basically getting tons of courses for the price of one, which is pretty mind-blowing. On top of that, you're also getting presets to speed up your editing workflow. I don't teach Photoshop, so if that's something you're interested in, there's tons of information on Photoshop as well as successfully running photography businesses. So there's really something in there for everyone, and I hope that you will give it a click and a checkout and snag it while you can. Today I want to talk to you about having confidence as a photographer. Oh, this is such a loaded topic. And it's something that I have yet to meet a photographer who doesn't struggle with this. It doesn't matter how long you've been shooting. I've been shooting for 11 years, and so a lot of my friends, we all kind of learned together. Just the other day, I was talking to one of my friends who I think is one of the best photographers I know, and she said she thinks she's getting worse. Like, what? Her photography is amazing. I also have another friend who is a professional food photographer that people pay her money, and she still sends photos every now and then. It's like, I don't think this is very good. And I'm just like, it's just something we all struggle with, and I want to make sure that you understand that. That having this like imposter syndrome and feeling that you're not good enough is unfortunately completely normal. I know that doesn't make it any better, but I just want to start off by letting you know that you are not alone if you feel like this. I feel like it all the time. Honestly, like, I look at my work and I'm like, how am I even teaching people photography? Like, this, it's just something that we all struggle with. And, you know, and it's hard. It's really hard to feel like you're not good enough at what you're doing. I will tell you that the more you learn, the more you're gonna doubt yourself. So I love plants and I always killed all my plants until we moved to England, and then I kept them alive and it was a miracle. Well, then I gave them all away to friends when we moved, and so we came back and I got new plants. And so a lot of these are plants that I have not ever had to care for. So I've been doing a lot of research on how to take care of these plants, and I've been diving really deep into that. As I'm learning more about how to take care of these plants, I'm learning different ways to water them, how to pot them, and I'm completely second guessing everything I've ever done. So I've changed the way I'm watering them, and half my plants are dying now. For 2 years, I took care of plants in England and didn't have a single problem, but it's because I'm learning more that I'm questioning myself. So as you learn more about photography, just know that you are going to question yourself and your abilities. It's just part of the cycle. I feel like learning about photography is kind of just like ups and downs. I typically feel more down the more I learn, because it makes you realize how much you have left to learn, and that really can mess with your confidence. Maybe your confidence is lacking when it comes to your photography business. Are you not sure how to set your pricing? I know that's something that is a big struggle with a lot of photographers, is how do you value your time and your work? In the photography bundle, there's an amazing course in there that'll help you price out your stuff. They walk through how to set your pricing, and it's definitely a must if you're in this area where you're not exactly sure how to price yourself, because you want to be confident in your pricing. And so as you continue to grow as a photographer, you're gonna hear that little voice that questions you and makes you wonder if you're good enough, and if maybe you're just an imposter. And I just want you to know that you're not, and you are good enough. I think one of the things that also affects our confidence as photographers is seeing other people's work in social media. And I want you to know that it is important to learn from other photographers, but you don't ever want to compare yourself to other photographers. In fact, the only person you should be comparing yourself to is yourself. So if you're in one of those waves where you're starting to question yourself, what I recommend you do is pull up one of your most recent favorite photos, and then pull up one of your photos when you first started, and then look at them. you will see growth. I know that's something that I do when I start to question myself is I'll go back through and look at old photos, even photos from 3 and 4 years ago. I can still see how much has changed. And so it's important that you remind yourself that you are on this journey and that you are growing and you don't need to worry about what anyone else is doing. Like I said, learn from them, but don't compare yourself to them. What I want you to take away is that you are on your own photography journey, and some things are just going to click and they're going to make sense for you, and other things are going to be harder and you're going to need to learn about them and dive deeper, and that's totally fine and completely normal. So no matter where you are on your journey, I just want you to remember that you have a unique perspective. I want you to keep picking up your camera, keep taking those photos, tell your story through your images, and don't forget to check out the photography bundle. Like I said, it is going away and I would hate for you to miss it. So go ahead and click the link, check it out, grab it while you still can, and thanks for joining us this week.